Mrs. and Mr. James Tillingham Young. For short, they are Della and Jim. Today is Christmas Eve, and so they are exchanging gifts. Just as everybody does, but there is something special in the exchange of gifts. When I say there is something special, I mean it. So be attentive and see how their gifts are very special.
$1.87, and tomorrow is Christmas. Let us take a look at her home, which is a furnished flat at $8 a week. You see signs of poverty wherever you turn your eyes. What else you expect when Della's husband, Mr. James Dillingham Young, earns $20 a week?
ਹੁਣ ਅਸੀਂ ਉਸ ਘਰ ਨੂੰ ਵੇਖਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਜਿਸ ਦਾ ਕਿਰਾਇਆ $8 ਪ੍ਰਤੀ ਹਫ਼ਤਾ ਸੀ। ਤੁਸੀਂ ਚਾਰੇ ਪਾਸੇ ਗਰੀਬੀ ਵੇਖੋਗੇ। ਤੁਸੀਂ ਕੀ ਉਮੀਦ ਕਰ ਸਕਦੇ ਹੋ? ਡੈਲਾ ਦੇ ਪਤੀ ਮਿਸਟਰ ਜੇਮਸ ਡਿਲਿੰਗਮ ਯੰਗ ਤੋਂ ਜੋ ਕਿ $20 ਪ੍ਰਤੀ ਹਫ਼ਤਾ ਕਮਾਉਂਦਾ ਸੀ।
Students, you just now saw the pathetic condition of Della and Jim. They were almost poverty stricken. Della finished crying. She went up to the looking glass and began to powder her cheeks. Then she stood by the window and looked out dully at a grey cat walking on a grey fence in a grey backyard. Tomorrow would be Christmas Day, and she had only $1.87 with which to buy Jim a present. She had been saving every penny she could for months with this result. $20 a week doesn't go far. Expenses had been greater than she had calculated. They always are. Only $1.87 to buy a present for Jim. Her Jim. Oh, the many happy hours she had spent planning for something nice for him. Something fine and rare. Worthy of the honor of being owned by Jim. ਡੈਲਾ ਨੇ ਰੋਣਾ ਬੰਦ ਕੀਤਾ। ਉਹ ਸ਼ੀਸ਼ੇ ਦੇ ਸਾਹਮਣੇ ਗਈ ਅਤੇ ਆਪਣੀਆਂ ਗੱਲਾਂ ਤੇ ਪਾਊਡਰ ਲਾਉਣ ਲੱਗੀ। ਫਿਰ ਉਹ ਖਿੜਕੀ ਦੇ ਕੋਲ ਜਾ ਕੇ ਖੜੀ ਹੋ ਗਈ ਅਤੇ ਉਦਾਸ ਮਨ ਨਾਲ ਬਾਹਰ ਨੂੰ ਵੇਖਿਆ ਜਿੱਥੇ ਇੱਕ ਧੌਲੇ ਰੰਗ ਦੀ ਬਿੱਲੀ ਪਿਛਵਾੜੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਧੌਲੇ ਰੰਗ ਦੀ ਫਸੀਲ ਤੇ ਚਲੀ ਜਾ ਰਹੀ ਸੀ। ਅਗਲਾ ਦਿਨ ਕ੍ਰਿਸਮਸ ਦਾ ਸੀ ਅਤੇ ਉਸ ਦੇ ਕੋਲ ਜਿਮ ਦੇ ਲਈ ਤੋਹਫ਼ਾ ਖਰੀਦਣ ਲਈ ਸਿਰਫ $1.87 ਸਨ। ਉਹ ਕਈ ਮਹੀਨਿਆਂ ਤੋਂ ਇੱਕ ਇੱਕ ਪੈਨੀ ਬਚਾਉਂਦੀ ਆ ਰਹੀ ਸੀ ਅਤੇ ਉਹ ਜੋ ਬਚਾ ਸਕਦੀ ਸੀ ਉਸਦਾ ਨਤੀਜਾ ਸਿਰਫ ਇਹੀ ਸੀ। ਹਰ ਹਫ਼ਤੇ $20 ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਨਹੀਂ ਚੱਲਦੇ ਸਨ, ਖਰਚ ਉਸ ਤੋਂ ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਹੋ ਜਾਇਆ ਕਰਦਾ ਜਿੰਨਾ ਉਹ ਅਨੁਮਾਨ ਲਾਉਂਦੀ ਸੀ। ਉਹ ਹਮੇਸ਼ਾ ਹੋ ਜਾਂਦੇ ਸਨ ਜਿਮ ਦੇ ਲਈ ਤੋਹਫ਼ਾ ਖਰੀਦਣ ਨੂੰ ਸਿਰਫ $1.87 ਹੀ ਸਨ। ਉਸਦਾ ਆਪਣਾ ਜਿਮ, ਉਹ ਕਿੰਨੇ ਖੁਸ਼ੀ ਦੇ ਘੰਟੇ ਉਸਨੇ ਜਿਮ ਦੇ ਲਈ ਕਿਸੇ ਵਧੀਆ ਚੀਜ਼ ਦੀ ਯੋਜਨਾ ਬਣਾਉਂਦੇ ਹੋਏ ਬਿਤਾਏ ਸਨ। ਕੋਈ ਅਜਿਹੀ ਚੀਜ਼ ਜੋ ਵਧੀਆ ਅਤੇ ਦੁਰਲੱਭ ਹੋਵੇ, ਜਿਹੜੀ ਜਿਮ ਦੁਆਰਾ ਰੱਖੇ ਜਾਣ ਦੇ ਲਾਇਕ ਹੋਵੇ। ਹੇਅਰ ਆਰ ਸਮ ਡਿਫੀਕਲਟ ਵਰਡਸ ਫਰੋਮ ਦ ਅਬਵ ਪੈਸੇਜ। Words, meanings, expenses, money spent, pav, kharcha, calculated, counted, pav, jod lagaya. Let's see what happens next.
Now, there were two possessions of the James Dillingham Youngs in which they both took great pride. One was Jim's gold watch that had been his father's and his grandfather's. The other was Della's hair.
ਹੁਣ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੇ ਕੋਲ ਦੋ ਹੀ ਬੇਸ਼ਕੀਮਤੀ ਚੀਜ਼ਾਂ ਸਨ ਜਿਨ੍ਹਾਂ ਤੇ ਉਹ ਮਾਣ ਮਹਿਸੂਸ ਕਰਦੇ ਸਨ। ਇੱਕ ਸੀ ਜਿਮ ਦੀ ਸੋਨੇ ਦੀ ਘੜੀ ਜੋ ਉਸਦੇ ਪਿਤਾ ਅਤੇ ਦਾਦੇ ਦੀ ਸੀ। ਦੂਜਾ ਸੀ Della de Waal.
Here are some difficult words from the passage. Words, meanings. Pride, honor, pav, maan. Possessions, state of owning or having something. Pav, Malkiyat, Sampatti. Let's see how Della sells her hair.
It was difficult to lose her beautiful hair, but for the sake of love, she got ready.
Will you buy my hair?
I buy hair. Take your hat off and let me have a look at it. $20.
Give it to me quickly.
So students, you saw Della selling her hair for $20. And with these $21.87 collected, she spent the next 2 hours shopping for a present for Jim. And here are a few questions. My first question is, why was Della crying? And the answer is, Della was crying because she had only $1.87 to buy a present for Jim. The next question is, describe the poverty of the house. And the answer is, there was a dirty little couch and her flat was furnished for $8 a week. The next question is, what type of present had Della planned for Jim? And the answer is, she had planned a fine and rare present worthy of the honor of being owned by him. The next question is, what were the two prized possessions of Jim and Della? And the answer is, one was Jim's gold watch that had been his father's and grandfather's, and the other was Della's hair. So what did Della find for Jim? See for yourself.
She found it at last. It surely had been made for Jim and no one else. There was no other like it in any of the stores. It was a platinum watch chain, simple but well made. It was worthy of the watch. As soon as she saw it, she decided that it was the right present for Jim. She paid $21 for it and hurried home with the 87 cents that remained.
Here are some difficult words from the above passage. Words, meanings. Platinum, a metal. Pav, ek tat. Worthy, respectable. Pav, like, siana. Now please answer the question. Why was Della pleased with her selection of the present for Jim? And the answer is, Della was pleased with the selection of her present because there was no other like it in any of the stores. It was a platinum watch chain, simple but well made. It was worthy of the watch. As soon as she saw it, she decided that it was the right present for Jim. ਅਖੀਰ ਵਿੱਚ ਉਸਨੇ ਗਿਫਟ ਲੱਭ ਲਿਆ ਉਸਨੂੰ ਉਹ ਚੀਜ਼ ਮਿਲ ਗਈ ਜੋ ਸਿਰਫ ਜਿਮ ਲਈ ਬਣੀ ਸੀ ਅਤੇ ਇਸ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਦੀ ਚੀਜ਼ ਕਿਸੇ ਵੀ ਸਟੋਰ ਤੇ ਮਿਲਣੀ ਆਸਾਨ ਨਹੀਂ ਸੀ
ਇਹ ਸੀ ਕੜੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਪਾਉਣ ਵਾਲੀ ਪਲੈਟੀਨਮ ਦੀ ਇੱਕ ਚੇਨ
ਉਹ ਸਾਦੀ ਅਤੇ ਬਹੁਤ ਹੀ ਸੋਹਣੇ ਟੰਗ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਬਣੀ ਹੋਈ ਸੀ ਉਹ ਇੰਨੀ ਮਹਿੰਗੀ ਕੜੀ ਦੇ ਕਾਬਿਲ ਸੀ ਉਸਨੇ ਉਸਨੂੰ ਵੇਖਦੇ ਸਾਰ ਹੀ ਜਿਮ ਲਈ ਖਰੀਦਣ ਦਾ ਫੈਸਲਾ ਕਰ ਲਿਆ ਉਸਨੇ $21 ਦਿੱਤੇ ਅਤੇ ਬਾਕੀ ਬਚੇ ਹੋਏ 87 ਸੈਂਟ ਲੈ ਕੇ ਘਰ ਆ ਗਈ ਨਾਓ ਪਲੀਜ਼ ਆਨਸਰ ਦ ਕੁਐਸਚਨਸ ਦ ਫਰਸਟ ਕੁਐਸਚਨ ਇਜ਼ ਡਿਸਕ੍ਰਾਈਬ ਦ ਪ੍ਰੈਜ਼ੈਂਟ ਡੈਲਾ ਬੋਟ ਫਾਰ ਹਿਮ ਐਂਡ ਦ ਆਨਸਰ ਇਜ਼ ਇਟ ਵਾਸ ਅ ਪਲੈਟੀਨਮ ਵਾਚ ਚੇਨ ਸਿੰਪਲ ਬਟ ਵੈਲ ਮੇਡ ਦ ਨੈਕਸਟ ਕੁਐਸਚਨ ਇਜ਼ ਹਾਊ ਡਿਡ ਡੈਲਾ ਮੈਨੇਜ ਟੂ ਬਾਏ ਦ ਗਿਫਟ And the answer is, she managed to buy the gift by selling her hair for $20. And students, after reaching home, she grew nervous.
When Della reached home, pleased with the present, she grew nervous as she thought calmly about what she had done. She looked at the reflection in the mirror long, carefully and critically. She brought out her curling irons and began to curl her hair carefully. The tiny curls made her look like a schoolboy.
ਜਦੋਂ ਡੈਲਾ ਆਪਣੇ ਘਰ ਪਹੁੰਚੀ ਤਾਂ ਉਹ ਆਪਣੇ ਖਰੀਦੇ ਹੋਏ ਗਿਫਟ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਬਹੁਤ ਖੁਸ਼ ਸੀ। ਉਹ ਘਬਰਾਉਣ ਲੱਗੀ ਅਤੇ ਆਰਾਮ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਸੋਚਿਆ ਕਿ ਉਸਨੇ ਇਹ ਕੀ ਕਰ ਦਿੱਤਾ। ਸ਼ੀਸ਼ੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਆਪਣੇ ਪ੍ਰਤੀਬਿੰਬ ਨੂੰ ਉਹ ਬੜੇ ਧਿਆਨ ਨਾਲ ਆਲੋਚਨਾਤਮਕ ਤਰੀਕੇ ਨਾਲ ਬਹੁਤ ਦੇਰ ਤੱਕ ਵੇਖਦੀ ਰਹੀ। ਉਸਨੇ ਵਾਲਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਘੁੰਗਰਾਲੇ ਕਰਨ ਲਈ ਲੋਹੇ ਵਾਲੀ ਕੰਘੀ ਕੱਢੀ ਅਤੇ ਆਪਣੇ ਵਾਲਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਘੁੰਗਰਾਲੇ ਕਰਨਾ ਸ਼ੁਰੂ ਕਰ ਦਿੱਤਾ।
Here are some difficult words from the passage. Words, meanings. Nervous, confused, Pav, kabraya hoya. Reflection, image, Pav, aks. Curling, to form something into a curl, Pav, kisi cheez nu kungrala banana. Critically, expressing disapproval, Pav, alochnatmak tarike naal. So students, Della was almost feeling afraid of facing her husband.
If Jim doesn't kill me before he takes a second look at me, he'll say, I look like a boy. But what could I do? Oh, what could I do with the $1.87?
Surely, children, you can answer this question after listening to the monologue or self-talking. My first question is, what did she think when she looked at herself in the mirror? And the answer is, she thought that her husband would not like her boyish looks. So with a troubled mind, she waited for her husband. At 7 o'clock, the coffee was made and everything arranged to get dinner ready. Jim was never late. Della sat on the corner of the table near the door with the watch chain in her hand. Then she heard his step on the stairs. She turned white for just a moment. She prayed, "Please God, make him think I'm still pretty." 7 baje usne coffee taiyar kar li ate mez te ਡਿਨਰ ਬਣਾਉਣ ਲਈ ਸਾਰਾ ਸਮਾਨ ਤਿਆਰ ਕਰਕੇ ਰੱਖ ਦਿੱਤਾ। ਜਿਮ ਕਦੇ ਵੀ ਦੇਰ ਨਹੀਂ ਕਰਦਾ ਸੀ। ਡੈਲਾ ਦਰਵਾਜ਼ੇ ਦੇ ਨੇੜੇ ਮੇਜ਼ ਤੇ ਇੱਕ ਪਾਸੇ ਹੱਥ ਵਿੱਚ ਚੇਨ ਫੜ ਕੇ ਬੈਠ ਗਈ। ਫਿਰ ਉਸਨੂੰ ਪੌੜੀਆਂ ਤੇ ਉਸਦੇ ਪੈਰਾਂ ਦੀ ਆਵਾਜ਼ ਸੁਣਾਈ ਦਿੱਤੀ। ਉਹ ਮੁੜੀ ਅਤੇ ਉਸਨੇ ਭਗਵਾਨ ਨੂੰ ਯਾਦ ਕੀਤਾ ਅਤੇ ਮਨ ਹੀ ਮਨ ਕਿਹਾ ਕਿ ਰੱਬਾ, ਉਸਨੂੰ ਮੈਂ ਹਾਲਾ ਵੀ ਸੁੰਦਰ ਲੱਗਾਂ। ਦ ਡੋਰ ਓਪਨਡ and Jim stepped in and closed it. He looked thin and very serious. Poor fellow, he was only 22 and he was burdened with a family. He needed a new overcoat and he was without gloves. Jim's eyes were fixed on Della and there was an expression in them that she could not read and it terrified her. It was not anger, nor surprise. He simply stared at her with a strange expression on his face. Darwaza khulya, ate Jim andar aya, ate darwaje nu band kar ditta. Oh bada kamzor lag raha si, te kambhir si. Oh sirf 22 saal da si, ate us te parivar da bojh aa pya. Usnu ek nave overcoat di zarurat si. ਅਤੇ ਉਸ ਕੋਲ ਦਸਤਾਨੇ ਨਹੀਂ ਸਨ। ਉਸ ਦੀਆਂ ਅੱਖਾਂ ਡੈਲਾ ਤੇ ਟਿਕੀਆਂ ਹੋਈਆਂ ਸਨ। ਉਸ ਦੀਆਂ ਅੱਖਾਂ ਵਿੱਚ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਭਾਵ ਸੀ ਉਹ ਸਮਝ ਨਹੀਂ ਪਾ ਰਹੀ ਸੀ ਅਤੇ ਡਰ ਰਹੀ ਸੀ। ਉਹ ਗੁੱਸੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਨਹੀਂ ਸੀ ਅਤੇ ਉਸਨੂੰ ਹੈਰਾਨੀ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੋ ਰਹੀ ਸੀ। ਉਹ ਉਸਨੂੰ ਇੱਕ ਅਜੀਬ ਤਰੀਕੇ ਨਾਲ ਟਿਕਟਿਕੀ ਲਾ ਕੇ ਵੇਖ ਰਿਹਾ ਸੀ। Here are some difficult words from the passage. Words, meanings. Burdened. Carry the burden of responsibility, work or worry. Pav, farz, kam ja chinta de paar thalle dabya hoya. Expression, look. Pav, dik. Gloves, covering of the hand. Pav, dastane. Now the question is, if he was not angry or surprised, what was it? He was shocked to see that the hair for which he had brought the combs were all gone. Children, you can get the answer to the question. Why does the story writer call Jim a poor fellow? The story writer calls Jim a poor fellow because he was only 22 and he was burdened with a family. He needed a new overcoat and he was without gloves. He earned $20 a week. Now let's see the conversation between Della and Jim and the reaction of Jim.
Jim, darling, don't look at me that way. I had my hair cut off and sold it because I had to buy a Christmas present for you. I just had to do it. My hair grows so fast. You don't mind, do you?
You have cut off your hair.
Cut it off and sold it. Don't you like me just as well without my hair?
You say, your hair is gone.
You needn't look for it. It's sold. I tell you, sold and gone. It's Christmas Eve. Jim, be good to me because I did it all for you.
You saw that Jim could not believe his eyes to see Della with haircut. Here are simple questions for you. The first question is, what was Jim's reaction on seeing her hair gone? Answer is, Jim was shocked to see her hair gone. The next question is, what explanation did Della give to him? And the answer is, she said that she got her hair cut and sold only for him. Moreover, her hair grew very fast. You can now imagine how deeply Della loved her husband, and soon we'll see what Jim did.
Don't make any mistake about me, Della. Whatever happens, I shall always love you just the same. Now open the package and you will understand why I behaved as I did.
Oh, for there lay the combs, the set of combs, side and back, that Della had seen in a Broadway window and liked so much. They were beautiful combs, so expensive, and they were hers now. But alas, the hair in which she was to wear them was sold and gone. She took them up lovingly, smiled through her tears and said,
Othe kangiyan da bahut sohna set paya si. Della ne kangiyan da eh set Broadway di khidki to vekhya si. Ate usnu ਇਹ ਬਹੁਤ ਹੀ ਪਸੰਦ ਆਇਆ ਸੀ। ਉਹ ਬਹੁਤ ਹੀ ਸੋਹਣੀਆਂ ਕੰਘੀਆਂ ਸਨ ਅਤੇ ਬਹੁਤ ਹੀ ਮਹਿੰਗੀਆਂ, ਪਰ ਹੁਣ ਇਹ ਉਸ ਦੀਆਂ ਸਨ। ਪਰ ਜਿੰਨਾ ਵਾਲਾਂ 'ਚ ਉਸਨੇ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਲਗਾਉਣਾ ਸੀ, ਉਹ ਹੁਣ ਵਿਕ ਚੁੱਕੇ ਸਨ। ਉਹ ਅੱਖਾਂ ਵਿੱਚ ਹੰਝੂ ਲੈ ਕੇ ਬਹੁਤ ਹੀ ਪਿਆਰ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਮੁਸਕਰਾਈ।
My hair grows so fast, Jim.
Here are some difficult words from the above passage. Words, meanings. Combs. A flat piece of metal or plastic with a row of teeth on one side to make hair neat. Paav, kangiyan. Expensive, costly. Paav, mehenga. Here is a simple question to you. What was in the package that Jim had brought for Della? The answer is, there was a set of beautiful expensive combs in the pack that Jim had brought for her. And now it was the turn of Jim to get shocked. He had not yet seen his beautiful present.
Isn't it lovely, Jim? I hunted all over town to find it. You'll have to look at your watch 100 times a day now. Give me your watch. I want to see how it looks on it.
Let's put our Christmas presents away and keep them for a while. They are too nice to use just at present. I sold the watch to get the money to buy your comms. And now, please get the dinner ready.
Children, you just heard James saying he sold his watch to get the money to buy her set of new combs. So if you get a question, how had Jim managed to bring the present for her? The answer is, Jim had managed to bring the present for her by selling his gold watch. My dear children, how did you like the story by O. Henry? The writer tells about the art of giving gifts on Christmas. In fact, the first men who brought gifts for Christ were the Magi. They are also called the wise men. The Magi brought gifts for the newborn Christ in Bethlehem. According to the Gospel of Matthew, the Magi found Jesus by following his star, which thus traditionally became known as the Star of Bethlehem. On finding him, they gave him 3 symbolic gifts. That is why the story is titled The Gift of the Magi. O. Henry has tried to equate Jim and Della with the Magi, the wise men. Both of them used their wisdom to buy very beautiful and much needed gifts as Christmas presents. But they failed in their attempt. In one thing they still did well was the selfless way in which they gave gifts. They parted with their most prized possessions. Della sold her beautiful hair for $20. She risked her husband's love too. He could have rejected her in her boyish looks. On the other hand, Jim sold his gold watch that had been his father's and his grandfather's never to get it back. Though Della wishfully hopes that her hair will grow very fast. So, their gifts were unusable at the moment. But they knew the art of giving gifts from their heart. ਉਹ ਆਪਣੀਆਂ ਕੋਸ਼ਿਸ਼ਾਂ ਵਿੱਚ ਨਾਕਾਮ ਹੋ ਗਏ। ਇੱਕ ਗੱਲ ਜੋ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਬਹੁਤ ਚੰਗੀ ਕੀਤੀ ਉਹ ਸੀ ਨਿਸਵਾਰਥ ਭਾਵਨਾ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਪੇਂਟ ਦੇਣਾ। ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਆਪਣੀ ਸਭ ਤੋਂ ਬਹੁਮੁੱਲੀ ਚੀਜ਼ ਜਿਹੜੀ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਸੀ ਨੂੰ ਆਪਣੇ ਆਪ ਤੋਂ ਅਲੱਗ ਕਰ ਦਿੱਤਾ। ਡੈਲਾ ਨੇ $20 ਵਿੱਚ ਆਪਣੇ ਬਾਲ ਵੇਚ ਦਿੱਤੇ ਅਤੇ ਇੱਥੋਂ ਤੱਕ ਕਿ ਆਪਣੇ ਪਤੀ ਦੇ ਪਿਆਰ ਨੂੰ ਵੀ ਦਾਅ ਤੇ ਲਗਾ ਦਿੱਤਾ। ਦੂਜੇ ਪਾਸੇ ਜਿਮ ਨੇ ਆਪਣੀ ਸੋਨੇ ਦੀ ਘੜੀ ਵੇਚ ਦਿੱਤੀ ਜੋ ਕਿ ਉਸਦੇ ਪਿਤਾ ਅਤੇ ਦਾਦੇ ਦੀ ਸੀ ਅਤੇ ਜੋ ਹੁਣ ਕਦੇ ਵੀ ਵਾਪਸ ਨਹੀਂ ਮਿਲਣੀ ਸੀ। ਡੈਲਾ ਨੂੰ ਉਮੀਦ ਸੀ ਕਿ ਉਸਦੇ ਵਾਲ ਜਲਦੀ ਹੀ ਵੱਧ ਜਾਣਗੇ ਪਰ ਇਸ ਸਮੇਂ ਦੋਹਾਂ ਦੀਆਂ ਪੇਟਾਂ ਇਸਤੇਮਾਲ ਨਹੀਂ ਕੀਤੀਆਂ ਜਾ ਸਕਦੀਆਂ ਸਨ ਪਰ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਦਿਲੋਂ ਪੇਂਟ ਕਰਨਾ ਆਉਂਦਾ ਸੀ। ਸੋ ਚਿਲਡਰਨ, ਯੂ ਗੋਟ ਦ ਮੈਸੇਜ ਰਾਈਟ। ਵਨ ਸ਼ੁੱਡ ਗਿਵ ਗਿਫਟਸ with love, not as a matter of routine or with selfish interest. Thank you. See you next time with more twist ending stories.